Good morning, everyone. My name is Mighty Stream. I'm going to do your October the 12th spiritual principle a day in a meditation. Hope you're doing well this morning. I'm excited to actually get through this meditation. So let's see if this take works for us, okay? The title of the meditation, Practicality in Action. It's not what we think about our recovery that matters, it's what we do. Living Clean, Chapter 1, Living Clean, Opening Essay. When we first come into recovery, we may think everyone in the room is lying. A member recalled thinking, they can't possibly be that happy. And really, no one can stay clean for 30 years, let alone 30 days in a row. We may even tell ourselves there's no way we can stop using and have a fulfilling life. Despite our internal monologue, we continue showing up to meetings and putting some clean time together. We take suggestions, pick up a commitment, get a sponsor, and begin working steps, all the while thinking, this won't work for me. We do our best to ignore that devious little voice inside us. After all, what we have been doing up to this point hasn't really been working either. As we take these practical actions, the heaviness lifts from our hearts. We experience moments of joy and freedom clean. We realize that we have been doing all of the things we told ourselves were not possible. Now we have 6 months clean, and our lives are so much fuller than we thought they could be. When we share in meetings, we realize that we've become those people who we thought were lying to us. One of the most practical things we do is to show up and tell the truth about our lives. When we no longer need to fabricate stories and justifications, it frees up a lot of mental energy. We share our victories, our process, and our mess as they are happening. While the disease still talks to us, nowadays, our recovery also chimes in to remind us that we're right where we're supposed to be. We're right where we're supposed to be. I like that. Doing the footwork frees us to live in the present. We have a solid foundation and a network of connections in our recovery community. Our world has become fuller and more fulfilling. We have found a family in Narcotics Anonymous. We want more of these gifts, so we continue to put one foot in front of the other, doing the things that brought us to this point. I will take a practical approach to my recovery today. I'll thank the committee in my head for sharing and take positive actions that enhance my recovery and my life. Let's take a moment of silence, followed by the we version of Serenity Prayer. Moment of silence now, please. Thank you. God, grant us the serenity to accept the things that we cannot change, the courage to change the things that we can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Just for today, please and thank you. Practicality in action. So we've heard it said, right? If it's not practical, it's not spiritual, right? And so sometimes what we do is, because of the disease of addiction and our character defects that go along with that, we have a tendency to be very skeptical about everything. We're skeptical about the people in the meeting, whether they're really clean or not. Why are they pretending like they haven't used anything? They must have used something, right? You're very skeptical. At least I was when I first came around. But here's the thing. Even though I was a skeptic, I could not make sense. I could not make it make sense for me to go back to using drugs. I could not. After I got that first 24 hours, which had never happened before, right? Well, maybe it had happened because I remember other times that I was like, I'm not going to drink because I have to be here at a certain time. And then when I get there, I can do anything that I want to do because I will be safe and sound, right? Thinking in those terms. Or I'm not going to use right now because I need to put on a presentation. When I get done with that presentation, they're going to take me out to eat and I will start there, right? So I'm not going to say that I would, you know, never experience having 24 hours clean. I have. But once I got it in recovery, right? Once I admitted that I was powerless over the disease of addiction and that my life had become unmanageable, I could not, after I got that first 24 hours, I could not make myself go back to picking up. Something that I had desired to achieve for the good portion of my life at that time, which was 25 years old, young, I could not see myself picking up. But I didn't come in here with this ideal that I'm going to stay here. But I found out, even with my skepticism, I was able to continue to come back to meetings, stay clean in between. And a lot of times there were many days in between my meeting attendance because I was driving across state lines to get to a meeting where I knew family members would be. I had such anxiety around people in general, and I wanted the comfort of being where they were. And so there were days, you know, months that would go by, many days, I shouldn't say months. I made at least one meeting a month. I don't recommend you do that. But I remember them saying, keep coming back, 90 meetings in 90 days, and don't use in between. But if you do, you come back. You keep coming back. It just made sense. And then eventually, the stuff that I used to doubt and be so skeptic about, I became a part of that don't use no matter what club. And I found myself doing and saying and volunteering my time to do service just like other people. Found myself cheerful, not ready to bite people's head off all of the time. And I was quite violent, right? So that was a stretch for me not to, you know, check people when I thought they were trying to bully me, shame me, or something like that. So I'm very grateful for my process. Are you? Are you grateful for your process? Taking a practical approach to your recovery today. Because I guarantee you, if you do it just for today, it'll give you a better opportunity to do it tomorrow. And when tomorrow gets here, you do the same thing. You do it just for today. When that stinking thinking, the committee in your head gets to talking, running its mouth, thank it for sharing and let it pass. Right? To the other more positive, recovery-based, spiritual, principle-based thoughts that you are developing and have. And if you cannot shut off that stinking thinking, that other voice, right? If you cannot shut that internal monologue off, my suggestion is that you reach out to someone. You get your numbers out, you call a few, text a few, and maybe even meet one for coffee and share. I want for you to have a beautiful day today, but you know what else I want for you? I want you to have a beautiful recovery. My name is Mighty Stream. I've enjoyed talking to you today, and I will be talking to you tomorrow. Have a beautiful day in the meantime, on purpose.